In this video, we're going to look at differentiating exponential functions. In a previous video, we looked at differentiating the exponential function. The exponential function is e to the x. An exponential function will be of the form y is equal to a to the x, where a is a positive constant. An example might be y is equal to 2 to the x, y is equal to 3 to the x, y is equal to 5 to the power of x squared plus 1, y is equal to 7 to the power of 3x minus 1. They are examples of exponential functions. Let's remind ourselves of how we found the derivative of e to the x. So what we did is wrote y is equal to e to the x. We took the natural log of both sides and had the natural log of y was equal to the natural log of e to the x. Using the power law, we brought the x down and we wrote the natural log of y was equal to x, the natural log of e. The natural log of e is 1, so we could simply write the natural log of y is equal to x. At this stage, we differentiated both sides of the equation with respect to x. On the left-hand side, I need to use implicit differentiation. With implicit differentiation, now I've got the natural log of y. I need to differentiate the natural log of y with respect to x. To do that, I differentiate with respect to y and then multiply through by dy by dx. So the derivative of the natural log of y with respect to y is 1 over y, and I multiply by dy by dx. I then now differentiate x with respect to x, which gives me 1. So multiplying both sides by y, dy by dx was equal to y. Now we know y is equal to e to the x in this case, so we can say that dy by dx was equal to e to the x. And that is a result that we can quote time and time again in our work. If y is equal to e to the x, then dy by dx is also equal to e to the x. Now let's move this on and let's say we have some positive constant a, such that we have y is equal to a to the x. So this isn't e, it's a. It might be 2, it might be 5, it might be 10. What we're going to do is replicate this up to a certain point. I want to find the derivative now of y is equal to a to the x. I want to differentiate this with respect to x. Taking logs of both sides, the natural log of y is equal to the natural log of a to the power of x. So we're doing exactly the same. Bringing the power down, the natural log of y is equal to x, the natural log of a. If I now consider here, what I said was the natural log of y was equal to x, because the natural log of e is 1. The natural log of a is not 1 unless a is equal to e, which would suggest at this point it's not. It's some other constant. It's 10, it's 20, it's 30, it's 6. So at this stage, I need to leave that alone. I'm going to come down here and differentiate both sides now with respect to x. So differentiating the natural log of y, we get 1 over y dy dx using implicit differentiation. Now let's consider differentiating x multiplied by the natural log of a. The natural log of a is just a constant. So if I'm differentiating x multiplied by the natural log of a with respect to x, I'm just going to get the natural log of a. If I was differentiating 2x, I'd get 2. If I was differentiating 10x, I'd get 10. If I differentiated a million x, I'd get a million. So this just leaves us now with the constant, the natural log of a. Multiplying both sides by y, dy by dx will be equal to y, the natural log of a. Now in this particular case, we know that y is equal to a to the x, so we can say that dy by dx will be equal to a to the power of x multiplied by the natural log of a. And that, again, is a result you can quote. If y is equal to a to the x, then dy by dx is equal to a to the x multiplied by the natural log of a, where the natural log of a is just a constant. At this stage, what we've got here is the natural log of e. That's what we've got. If I'd left that in, that's down here. So all we've got now is our base a raised to the power of x multiplied by the natural log of a. Okay, let's look at that in action then. If y is equal to 2 to the x, the derivative dy by dx will be as straightforward as 2 to the x multiplied by the natural log of 2. Nice and easy. If y is equal to 3 to the x, remember a is a positive constant, then we can say that dy by dx will be equal to 3 to the x, the natural log of 3. And it's nice and logical and nice and straightforward. Okay, what we're going to do is move on and look at functions of functions. So, for example now, if I had y is equal to, let's say we had y is equal to e to the 2x plus 1. This is a function of a function or a composite function. I've got e to the x and I've got 2x plus 1. When we had a problem like this, we used the chain rule. We differentiated the outside function, which gave us e to the x, and then multiplied through by the derivative of the inside function. So what we'd have then is dy by dx would be equal to 2e to the 2x plus 1. So all I've done is differentiated the outside function. And of course, differentiating e to the x gives us e to the x, and then we multiply through. So if, for example, we had y is equal to e to the x squared plus, let's say, 4x, then the derivative would be now dy by dx. We would simply write now e to the x squared plus 4x and then multiply through by the derivative of the inside function, which is going to be 2x plus 4. So that was nice and straightforward, and we've looked at many cases of that. What we're now going to do is look at differentiating an exponential function rather than the exponential function, and look at a function of a function. So let's say we've got now y is equal to 2 to the power now of 4x plus 1, and we want to find now the derivative. Now, if I differentiate 2 to the x, I'm going to get 2 to the x for natural log of 2. So I can now write dy by dx using the chain rule. We can write that this is going to be 2 to the power of 4x plus 1 multiplied now by the natural log of 2, multiplied through by the derivative of the inside function, which is just going to be 4. So I could say now that dy by dx is going to be now 4 the natural log of 2, or any manipulation of this, if you wanted to bring that power, the natural log of 16, or anything along those lines, multiplied by 2 to the power of 4x plus 1. So that now is the derivative. Don't get caught up trying to blend these two and make some kind of new baby. Just leave it as it is. So if we had now y is equal to, let's say we had 3 to the power now of, let's go for x squared minus x plus 1, and we wanted the derivative. So if we said that this was y was equal to 3 to the u, where u was x squared minus x plus 1, we would differentiate the outside function, which would give us 3 to the u ln of 3, and then multiply through by the derivative of u with respect to x. So if you wanted a formal chain rule approach, you could take that. I'm just going to do it informally, as I'm assuming that you're happy with that. I might do an example here if you're not. So what we'd have then, dy by dx, if we differentiate the outside function and leave the inside function alone, we're going to get 3 to the x squared minus x plus 1, multiplied now by the natural log of 3, multiplied now by the derivative of the inside function, which is going to be 2x minus 1. So if we just tidy this up, what we've got, dy by dx will be equal to the natural log of 3, so the natural log of 3 multiplied by 2x minus 1 multiplied now by 3 to the power of x squared minus x plus 1. So that is the derivative. Now, when I'm talking about this inside function business, let's just apply it here. Let's now say that y is equal to e to the 2x plus 1. Okay, what we're going to do is make a substitution. What we'll say is let u be equal to 2x plus 1. So what we've got here now is y is equal to e to the u, where u is 2x plus 1. Now, by the chain rule, what we can say at this stage is the following. We can say that dy by dx will be equal to dy by du multiplied by du dx. So let's now use this. If we know that u is equal to 2x plus 1 and y is equal to e to the u, then what I'm going to do is get dy by du. Differentiating y with respect to u, dy by du will just give us e to the u. If we consider du dx, differentiating u with respect to x, we get du dx will be equal to 2. Therefore, by the chain rule, dy by dx, so dy by dx will be equal to 2e to the u. Now, we know that u is the 2x plus 1 that we've got just here, so we can just sub that back in. So that's what we've got. And as you can see, that's a long-winded way. But if you wanted a more formal approach, that's what you would get. Now, exactly the same would happen here. What we would have, if we took it from this stage, we would say, now, let's write it here. Y is equal to 3 to the power of x squared minus x plus 1. And we would say, now, let u be equal to the inside function that we have now. Let's just write that instead of writing the whole thing back out. U is going to be equal to x squared minus x plus 1. Okay, so let's write this here. So what we've got then, let u be equal to x squared minus x plus 1, which is the inside function. So what we have here now is y is equal to, so y is equal to 3 to the u. Okay, we can say that dy by dx is equal now to dy by du multiplied by du dx. So this now is the formal approach. As I've been doing it informally, I feel that I just need to clarify what I've been doing if you're not happy with this sort of informal approach. So let's consider now dy by du. If we now differentiate 3 to the u, we're going to get 3 to the u multiplied by the natural log of 3. So that's my dy by du. I need to multiply that by du dx. So if we consider now du dx, du dx is going to be the derivative of u with respect to x, which is going to be 2x minus 1. So that's now what we've got. And of course, all we need to do by the chain rule is write dy by dx is dy du. So we're going to get 3 to the u, and I'll just bracket this off, multiplied by the natural log of 3, multiplied now by du dx. And that's going to give me 2x minus 1. Now, we're still left with a u here, so we can write dy by dx and just subbing that in. We've got 3 to the power of u. Well, u is this function right here, x squared minus x plus 1. So x squared minus x plus 1, multiplied now by the natural log of 3, multiplied by 2x minus 1, which we saw anyway when we did it informally. So there we go. Where are we with our derivative? There we go. Exactly the same. So this is just, if you're asked to show why, there we go. Okay, let's move on and look at some of this now in context.